Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about LiPo battery repair. This is a 4S Funfly battery pack, and as you can see on the battery checker, one of the cells is only showing 3.8 volts fully charged. This causes issues when using the battery because it drops down to below 3.5 volts almost immediately with any sort of load put on the battery. So to fix this, what we're going to do is replace this bad cell with a good cell from another damaged battery that I have here. One important thing to note is that the cells you're using should be identical, meaning that they're coming from the exact same type of battery. To do this repair, we're going to be working with an X-Acto knife, and there are some serious risks involved when dealing with LiPo batteries. So before we get started, let's take a closer look at some of the dangers.
So what we're going to do is we're going to do a test of what happens if you were to puncture one of these lithium cells with the X-Acto knife that we're using. But first, we're going to talk about safety measures, safety glasses. Safety is a huge priority here. Gloves, extendable stick. Don't want to be too close to this thing. And we got a fire extinguisher right here, just in case. Okay, well, here we go. You can go ahead and poke this thing and see what happens. So at the moment, nothing's happening. this battery has 2 volts in it. So I would have expected it to have some sort of igniting. But at the moment, it doesn't seem to be doing anything. Okay, so the first battery didn't actually explode, which is kind of a surprise. But it was a little weak. It was only about 2 volts. This one here is actually 2 cells taped together. And in total, it's 8.4 volts, so it's about 4.2 volts, almost fully charged. This one should explode, theoretically. Let's go ahead and try this again. Saw the gas and fumes coming out. You wouldn't want to breathe that, especially if you're indoors. You can see the tip of the knife actually is kind of bent and melted, so that's some hot fire that's coming out of there.
GoPro is getting there. Okay, so now you know about the dangers of working with these batteries, so let's go ahead and keep going. What we're doing here is we're just cutting open the top part of the battery to try to expose the positive and negative terminals. You want to remove the tape, the cardboard, and this piece of foam, and just kind of notice that the terminals are covered in tape that protect any sort of shorting. We're going to be replacing this when we're done and putting the battery back together. You have to continue to remove little bits of tape. We're just trying to get the casing, the covering off the battery. Here's this metal plate that protects from punctures. Remember, you do not want to puncture this battery. When you're cutting this tape off, it is very easy to nick one of these batteries, and you saw what happened in the video, so let's not do that. So what we're going to do here now is separate the cell that we're going to be removing as a replacement for our other battery. Before we do this, I like to mark them with a positive and negative. This just helps to keep things straight as you're going forward with this repair. The first wire we're going to cut is the negative lead. When you're working with batteries, it's always good to start with the negative. And be very careful when cutting the terminals because you can actually arc the tool between the battery terminals themselves, creating spark and potentially even a fire. Now, in order to verify that this battery cell is in fact good, we're going to use a multimeter and measure between the positive and negative terminal. You can see here that we have between 4.18 and 4.2 volts. This battery cell is fully charged, and if you remember what I said, this is actually very bad. You should not be working on a battery that's fully charged. Do as I say, not as I do. I like to mark each cell with what it actually is. This one cell came from a 1300 milliamp hour. It's a 4-cell battery, so it's 325 milliamperes. This is the bad cell, so I'm marking it with an X. We're going to be disposing of it. For storage, I'm going to put some tape over the terminals. This is just to protect from any arcing. Better to be safe than sorry in this particular situation. So here we have the bad cell that we're going to be removing. So again, go ahead and cut your negative lead, being careful not to touch the positive and negative terminals together, because again, it will create sparks and potentially fire. And go ahead and cut the positive lead off now. So now we're going to place the good cell that we removed from the donor battery onto the battery that we're repairing. Make sure that the positive and the negative connections are correctly positioned. This is why we marked them earlier, to make it easier to remember which way they're supposed to go. I'm going to take a little bit of electrical tape here and just tape up the battery. This is to hold the cells together, and it makes it easier to work on. So next we need to solder up the positive connection here, and we want to make sure that it's a real nice connection here. So I'm going to put a bunch of solder on here, make sure it gets nice and hot and get a good connection. Now I'm going to move on to the negative lead, and you have to tin the wire that you have cut off. You want to make sure to have a really nice tin on there. This is going to make your soldering very easy. And you can see here I'm heating up the negative terminal and attaching the wire, which is pretty easy. Okay, so now that that's attached, everything should be good to go, and we're going to put the battery back together in the exact reverse steps that we used to take it apart. When I'm done with it, I like to make sure to tape up all the terminals and to tape up the battery completely back together, and it's basically good as new. So let's go ahead and test it with the battery voltage checker. And you can go ahead and see that we have 4.19, 4.18 volts on every single cell. This battery is good as new. Success.